Hello everyone. In order to separate gold from copper, you must have a plan. Step 1. You must specify the average carat value of the gold you wish to split and purify. Step 2. Determine the percentage of base metals from there. The procedure to follow is called inquiry. The less passive the substance you are working with, the less resistant to acid digestion, the easier your work will be. Separating a small percentage of gold from a large percentage of copper is much easier than separating a large percentage of gold from a small percentage of copper. But I prefer to show all the steps in several videos to explain it to all my followers in a simple way. Gold and copper alloys as another simple case. Suppose you have some clean yellow gold, scrap copper and gold. The higher the purity of gold, the more passive it is and the tougher it will be to separate it from an alloy. In this case, copper. The copper in the gold is called the base metal. This is what you want to part from the pure gold and dispose of. As in the case of the silver, copper alloy. In order to part the gold, copper alloy, you must have a plan. Step 1. You must determine the average carat value of the gold you wish to part and refine. If the gold is stamped 14 knots, locked, or some other carat value, as most gold jewelry is, you already know what you are supposed to have and can figure the percent of base metal from there. If you multiply the carat mark by 4.16, you have the percentage by weight of gold. If a piece of gold is marked 14 knots and you multiply this by 4.16, you find that the percentage weights are 58.24% for the gold and 41.75% for the base metal. 24 carat gold is pure 100% gold. As you can see by multiplying the carat 24 by the carat factor 4.16, the product 99.8 for rounds to 100%. If the gold is not marked, check it with your set of gold needles. With the gold in question, make a short mark on a touchstone, a piece of unglazed porcelain, or a clean white Arkansas whetstone. Now, make a guess at the unknown gold's carat value, say 14 knots. On one side of the unknown mark, then, put a mark with a 12 knots needle, and on the other side, a mark with a 16 knots needle. Then place a drop of aqua regia on each of the three marks. Now watch the three marks dissolve. If the 12th knot line dissolves first, then the unknown next, then the 16 knots mark, you will know that the carat of your unknown is greater than 12, but less than 16 and therefore probably 14. If your unknown disappears before the 12 knots mark does, it is of a lower carat than 12. Conversely, if the unknown disappears last, it is of a higher carat than 16. By changing the needles, you can pin your approximate carat very close. The less passive that is, less resistant to digesting in an acid. The material you work with is, the easier your job is. It is much easier to part a small percentage of gold from a large percentage of copper than to part a large percentage of gold from a small percentage of copper. The procedure you must follow is called inquiry. This means adding copper to the alloy you wish to part in order to lower its carat value to 6 knots or lower. At that point, the parting process becomes a copper proposition. Step 2. Inquiry is the reduction of the carat of a given quantity of gold scrap to 6 knots or below, so that 3/4 of the material's weight is copper and 1/4 of it is gold. Although carat gold is much easier to refine, extract pure gold from than a higher carat gold, because the acids used in refining get at the base metals much more easily in the former case. If you have 1 troy ounce of gold scrap that you figure averages about 12 knots, some pieces being 10 knots and some 14 knots, how much copper must you add to reduce it all to 6 knots or lower? The formula for lowering the carat to 6 knots is A equals G tilde minus 6, where A is the amount of copper you need, G is the weight of your gold scrap, and K is the average carat of the scrap.